Hello everyone, so today's video is going to be about adding disk, partitions and file system to a Linux machine. So after we are done with this chapter, we will be able to create and remove disk partitions with an MBR partitioning scheme, and we will be using fdisk command for that. The other one is the GPT partitioning scheme, and we use gdisk command in that, right? And the second thing is we will be able to format the devices with Linux file system. ext4 and XFS file systems are used, and we will be using mkfs command to put the file system in the partitions. And third thing is we will be able to mount those partitions on the mount points so in our machine. So why we use the disk partitioning? There can be various reasons. The basic one is that it helps us to divide the space into multiple logical units, and we can perform various functions in those units. For example, we can limit the available space to applications and users, or in case we want to allow the multi-booting of different operating systems from the same disk. So there can be various reasons why we want to perform the disk partitioning. So let's just start it. And what we will do, so I have attached 8 GB of storage device to this Linux system. So when we run this command fdisk-l, then it will display us the storage devices. So this is /dev/sda, so it is approximately 20 GB of space, and in this we have already installed Linux. So three partitions are made automatically when we did the installation according to the recommended procedure. So it just created these three partitions. And this is the storage device which I have just attached, and it is /dev/sdb, because we know that all the devices they are displayed in /dev directory size. So what we are going to do, we are going to use this device, and we are going to partition it into, for example, I am going to do two partitions. So one will be of 3 GB and second will be of 5 GB. And what I want to do, I want to, for example, I want to store some documents in that 3 GB of space, and I want to store some software in that 5 GB of space. So this is my purpose for which I want to do the partitions. So what I need to do now, so fdisk is the command, fdisk is the utility. We will write fdisk, and which device we want to manage with it, which storage device we want to manage with it, that is /dev/sdb. Be very careful, because don't try to write here /dev/sda, because that will take you to the manipulation of sda disk in which you have already installed your Linux machine. So you are going to partition sdb device, right? So fdisk /dev/sdb, and then just press enter. So this is one interface which is open, and it is displaying that changes will remain in memory only until you decide to write them. Be very careful before using the write command. So I'll just explain it. So here, if we don't know that what command is used for what purpose, so we can just press M is for help, and it is going to display you all the things, all the commands. And what we want now, we want to create two partitions, right? So we can see that N is the command which is used to add a new partition. So we have 8 GB of space which we are going to divide into 3 GB and 5 GB. So I will just press N here and press enter, because I want to create a new partition. So it is displaying P or E, and P is by default, which is the primary partition. So what happens in MBR partitioning scheme using fdisk command, it supports four primary partitions. and by default it is P, so I'm just going to press enter, and then it is asking the partition number. Obviously you want your partition number to start from 1, so it is by default 1, and I'm just pressing enter. So first sector means this is the sector number from which you want to start your first partition. So the first available sector is 2048, so obviously we will just press enter here because we don't want to waste any space. So if I write here 3000 or something, so that means that our first partition will start from 3000 sector. So obviously 2048 to 3000, that space will be wasted, so that will be fragmentation, memory fragmentation, so we don't want it. So we will just press enter here, and it is asking us to enter the last sector number. So here what we want to create a partition of 3 GB of space. So there is an easier method for that. We will just press plus sign and then 3G. So 3G means wherever the first sector is starting, just calculate plus 3 GB of space, and wherever it ends, just mark it as the last sector, right? Because we are not calculating the actual sector number, that when 3 GB of space will end and what will be the sector number. So we have not calculated it. So it is an easier way. So you just write plus 3G or plus 5G, or if you want to just make a partition of some MB, then plus 500M. So you can specify the size into K, M or G. So I have written here plus 3G, and when I press enter, it will create one partition of type Linux and size will be 3 GB, right? So our first partition is already created, and now we want to create the second partition of the space whichever is left to us. So N primary partition, and partition number is obviously by default 2, and first sector is default number it is displaying you. So means if you had calculated how much space 3 GB takes, then it would have come out to be this much sector number. So this is the easier way. So first sector of the second partition, it is starting from this location. So obviously again you don't want to waste the memory, so wherever it is start, the first partition is ending, right from the next sector number you want to start your second partition. So just press enter here, and where is the last sector? So this is the whole space which is available. So by default it is specifying the last sector number, so we will just go with it. So second partition is created of 5 GB of space. So now our two partitions are already created, and there is one command P. When you write P and press enter, it will print you the partition table. So /deb/sdb1 and /deb/sdb2, two partitions are created and they are of type Linux. And now you have to be very careful. If you are sure that whatever we have done, you wanted to do the same, then you can press W here. That means you want to write the changes into the operating system. In case you don't want to write and you are not sure about it, you will just write Q and you will come out of it. You will just quit from this. So the changes will not be saved. So we have to be very careful before using this W command. So when you write W, that means your partition table is altered. So there is one more command, which is part probe. If you want to inform the operating system about those changes, because kernel is still following the old partition table, so if you want to inform the operating system to reread the partition table, so we need to fire this command part probe and then /deb/sdb, because this is the block storage device in which you have made the changes. So part probe /deb/sdb. So now our kernel is is following the new partition table. So you can run this command fdisk-l. So it is now displaying you that /dev/sdb is now partitioned into two partitions, two parts. One is sdb1 and second is sdb2. Right. So now, in case you want to store data in this partition, so what we need to do, we need to firstly tell that how the data is to be written into the partitions and how it is to be read. So file system is the program which helps us to do that. So in Linux there are ext4 and xfs file systems which are used. You can use any one of those. So mkfs is the command, mkfs then dot, suppose we are going to just put xfs file system into the partitions. So mkfs dot xfs and then /dev/sdb1 and press enter. So it has written xfs file system into the partition. In the same way, now suppose we want to write ext4 file system onto this /dev/sdb2 partition. So you will write mkfs.ext4 and then press enter. So it has written. There is one more way to put the file system in, that is mkfs and then -t and then xfs or ext4 then /dev/sdb1 or 2, whatever the partition number is. So -t means type of the file system, and here you will specify the type of file system. It can be XFS or ext4 because they are the two file systems which are used right now. The earlier ext2 and ext3 were also there, which are not currently used. Right, so we have put the file system in the partitions. So now, in order to use the partitions, we need to mount those partitions into the on some mount points. So we are going to create those mount points first. See, we have /mnt and /media directories also, which are already provided by Linux, but they are used for mounting the removable devices. But in case you just want to extend the space of Linux machine, like here we are doing, means we just want to store our documents and our software and we don't have much space left. So what we did, we just attached 8 GB of space and we did its partition, and we are going to store our documents into 3 GB, and we are going to store our softwares into that 5 GB of space. See, it can be used for any reason. Maybe you want to store your backup files into those partitions. We'll do. We have to make the mount points, and mount points are just the directories. So we are going to create two directories inside slash, and one will be. I'm just going to give the corresponding names, documents, and slash softwares. So two directories I have created. Now mount command is used to mount the device on the directories. So mount /dev/sdb1, I'm going to mount it on /documents directory, and in the same way I'm going to mount my second partition on softwares directory. Right, so now if you just run this mount command, you will be able to see that we have /dev/sdb1, which is mounted on documents, and file system xfs is there in the partition, and there is sdb2, which is mounted on software, and both are readable and writable. Okay, so there is one more command, df-h. When you run this command, it will display you all the storage devices. Like we have SDA, we have SR0. SR0 is the CD which I have attached, my DVD which I have attached here, and SDB1 and SDB2, two directories are there, and they are approximately 3 GB and 5 GB, and they are mounted on /documents and /software directory. So now whatever I am storing into /documents directory, that will be stored into that 3 GB of the partition, 3 GB of space, and whatever I am storing in /software directory, it is going to be written into that 5 GB of the space, right? But still one thing is there, that these two mount points are the temporary mount points, and the mounting that we have done is temporary. Means once we just switch off our machine, then these devices will be unmounted, right? So in case you want to mount these devices permanently on these mount points, then we have to make entry into the configuration file. So there is one configuration file inside /etc directory which is related to file system table. So the name of that file is /etc/fs-tab file system table, and you just view the contents of the file, then it is displaying you all those devices which are permanently mounted. So this file is read at the time of starting your machine. When you boot your machine, at that time this file is read, and whatever device is mounted on whichever directory, it is done in that way, right? So here UUIDs of all the devices, they are displayed. So this is our SDB, SDA1, SDA2 and SDA3, and /boot and swap, they are the mount points, and these are the file systems, and these are defaults, and this is file system, this is used for file system checking at the time of rebooting, right? So if you want to mount these devices also permanently, then we need to make their entry into the file, right? So there is one command, blkid, which will display you the block ID of your devices. So here SDB1 and SDB2, these two devices, these two partitions, they are having these UUIDs. So you have to just open this file in VIM editor, fs tab, and then you have to make entry of that UUID of the first partition, then UUID of the second partition, and then the mount points, they are /software and /documents, and then the file system whichever is put on in that, in those partitions, XFS and ext4, and then defaults and 00. You have to make the same entry in the file, and if there is any problem in this file, then your system will not be able to start in the right way. So just be very careful. So after editing this file, what you can do, there is one command, mount-a. So this is the command if there is everything, if all the mounting is done correctly, then this will not display any error. But if there is any problem in the mounting, or if there is any problem in this fstab file, then this will display you the error, right? So you should fix that problem before rebooting your machine, right? Otherwise we need to do the troubleshooting, troubleshooting can be done in case we have taken the appropriate precautions and measures before. So this is the way to do the permanent on these two directories. For example, if I just show the permissions on /documents, then you can see that user of the directory is root, and group is also root, and 755 are the permissions. Now for example, I want that only the persons in HR group, they should be able to store some documents into this document directory. So what I will do, I will change the group of this directory to HR, and then I will give the permissions in that way, right? So after setting the permissions in that way, the persons who are the part of that HR group, they will be having those permissions which you have set on this directory. So in this way, what you are doing, you are just controlling the access on that partition, right? So you can just interlink the concepts that we learned in ACL and in chmod command and in file and directory permissions. So you can just interlink the concepts and you can use them according to your requirement, right? So what we did in this chapter, that is, firstly we learned how to create the partition. So for creating the partition, fdisk command is used. You just have to write fdisk and then the storage device, and after that it will take you to that interface. You just need to press N to create a new partition. You just specify the starting and ending location, and after you are done with creating the partitions, then you just have to write those changes. So press W. So after writing, then you have to inform the operating system about the partition table changes. So part probe command is used. Then we will put the file system, and then we will make the mount points, and we will do the mounting. And to do the permanent mounting, we make the entry into fstab file. Right, now in case you want to delete those partitions now, so let's just rewind everything. So we know that in slash there are documents and software directories which are used as the mount points. So in case I want to just erase everything, then what I will do first, I will try to remove this documents directory. But if you try to do it, then it will display error that cannot remove slash document directory because device is busy, because this is not a normal directory, but it is a mount point, right? It is linked with the device. So before that, you need to unmount the device. Right. If you have made entry into fstab file, you have to remove that entry first, and then you will do the unmounting. Right. So I'm just unmounting the documents directory, and in the same way I'm unmounting the softwares directory. And then now you can remove this directory, and you can remove the softwares directory also. So this thing we are doing in case you don't need the content, you don't need anything which is stored in the partitions, right? So after removing these directories, now slash dev slash sdb, and if you write p, it will display you that two partitions are still there, and d command is used to delete the partition. By default, the second partition it is taking, so I'm deleting it and deleting the first partition also. And now if you're sure, then only just fire w command, otherwise just q and quit, just type q and quit from it, right? And then part probe, and after that slash dev slash sdb, right? And now if you run this fdisk hyphen l command, it is going to display you that we have sda and sdb, which is just present as in blank disk, right? So this is the way we do the partitions, and we put the file system, and we remove the partitions if they are not needed. So way in which we use fdisk command, and fdisk command is MBR partitioning scheme which is used since 1982, and it supports four primary partitions. And by using the logical or extended partitions, you can create a maximum of 15 partitions, and the size of every partition can be maximum 2 TB. But there is second partitioning method, which is GPT, and in which we use gdisk command, and it supports 128 partitions, and the size of partition can be very much. It can be up to 8 zettabyte. So second partitioning method can also be used in case you want to have multiple part in case you want to have more than 15 partitions and there is much bigger larger space, then we will use GPT partition. So that's all about adding disk partitions and file system to a Linux machine. So I hope this tutorial was helpful to you. Thank you so much.